Hello, welcome to Team Fortress TV. They're live already on the... this is Karana, it's a bit of deciding map, and we miss it again, but Osomniac have a dominant start. We'll get better at this. There's only a few games left, but we'll get better.
But eventually we'll cast the first round.
Yeah.
We'll cast the first mid-fight eventually.
Basically, what you need to know for this is... This is Osomniac versus Zyme. This is the third map in a best of three. They're tied up right now. The loser of this is out by 52, but forever. And the winner advances on to play, I think, Classic Mix-Up. Or most likely Classic Mix-Up right now. Osomniac have just stormed the first mid, have a full Uber advantage, will be pushing to the last. Sheep's on the defensive sniper. I think we're going to come on left-hand side now, talk me through it, Sideshow.
The Uber's coming in from Zebesai and Kadus. They get position on this top pipe. There's no Uber coming out from IM because Bonobo died at the mid. Aporia and Turmo do go down, but Kadus, Zebes, and Stark all get picked up by Sheep and Yuki, and that's going to be a fail push in. Uber v non-Uber for Osomniac, and a great hold from IM if they rotate themselves over to the left-hand side from the defender's perspective, getting away from the entirety of that Uber charge. And what is Merlin doing?
He was having a one-on-one with Sheep, he sawed him.
He's not going to get out of here.
No.
He makes some incredible plays sometimes, but that one was just a little step too far, and he's not able to get out of there, and he does give himself an incredibly long spawn. So that's going to put him at a severe disadvantage. Bonobo now has the Uber charge. Both the scouts have already got into the granary mid, so they're going to pick this up for absolutely for free. There's no heals for the Osomniac players, so they can't contest at all. They might be able to force it in yard here as they come. Kadus has got some stickies in the ramp room, and Zebesai and Nutsen are kind of holding on this.
He's left. Kipper was so close to the stickies right there. They're slightly too up. Yard for pretty now. Looks like they were just playing after they went. Okay, I'll work at holding my button down. Sorry, Sideshow. As the Uber comes in right now from IM, they're going to crush Zebesai. They're going to chase Merlin of last. Merlin is trying to dodge. He's still on 100 health. How is he still on 100 health? His health's only going up. Sheep's trying to get on him now, and Merlin will survive once again. Aporia is doing a big jump all the way in. He will go down as well, and Merlin eventually loses some health despite four people being on him.
Goodness me, great dodging from Merlin. He does survive there despite going down before. And he survived with now a 70% Uber advantage, but Bonobo has yet to spawn. He spawns in 5 seconds, and Merlin and his team of Osomniacs are going to have a full Uber advantage to push into this midpoint. Turmo has put some stickies up on the outside of that ramp room, but it looks like Osomniac are going to be going top here. There are two stickies. Stark sees them, they are dead. And both the soldiers for Osomniac coming out here, trying to put some pressure onto Ayan. Aporia does go down. He was the last one left in mid as the rest of Ayan back out. They don't try and force Merlin. They've backed out. They have the 30% advantage for Zebesai. Bomb didn't hit, picking Snowblind in the yard. Merlin still hasn't used his Uber charge. Stark and Nutsen on pretty low HP, but there's going to be no resistance from IM as they pick up Sheep. Zappa's getting the credit for that kill. There's a few stickies here as they walk through. Is Merlin going to... Oh, they do get dead by Turmo. Turmo with a blind dead, but he's just a little bit too early there.
And yeah, a great play from Osomniac. Not having to use now Uber, and they mean they're going to have it for last. I think Bonobo should have it in time. Osomniac aren't going to be close enough to go straight away. We're going to see an equal Uber exchange. Cookie cutter alignments for both sides. And Osomniac just deciding where they want to go right now, taking their time, buffing up people, and maybe a suicide from Zebesai and Zappas up top now.
Very defensive stickies from Kadus. That's a surefire sign of them doing a suicide. Zebesai bombs in, Zappas takes down Sheep, but Zebesai gets fragged instantly, and Turmo picks up Zappas as well. This is going to prompt the push into second from IM. They're going to meet the stickies that Kadus has laid down on the left-hand side and the right-hand side. Aporia is pushing into garage there, but does get picked up by Kadus. It hits a nice pipe on the top area, and that's going to stunt the push from IM. They back off to their last, and it's now a 6v4 situation in favor of Osomniac as they have the Uber to possibly push in, but Aporia is going to spawn in 3 seconds. Sheep has already spawned, so I think we're going to see another little stalemate as Stark is on... Zappas is on Sniper.
I think Zappas is the better sniper out of the scout pair as well, so we can see what he can do if he has real opportunity to snipe aggressively at this lap. And there we go, there goes Aporia. He gets one, but oh wow, they all get caught out. It ends up being a 2-for-2 trade. It's not the end of the world, but there was so much damage on Osomniac right now. It could have been a lot worse.
I thought it was going to go a lot worse there. I thought maybe IM were going to push into them with all the damage that Turmo had done. He got two kills there and put another two players on incredibly low HP. And Aporia and Sheep about to spawn. And that's going to make it another 6v6 situation. Zappas didn't die on the sniper, despite being the one that that was peeking in there, putting the pressure onto IM. He's going to be peeking from the left-hand side again, with Zebesai opening the door for him. He does get a shot onto Snowblind. Snowblind down to 18 HP, but he's not going to pick up the frag yet. And Turmo's going to be putting the spam on that right-hand side from the defender's perspective, which is going to force the rotate out of Orsomniac. Zapisai taking a lot of damage there from Yuki as he holds aggressively on the left-hand side. Zapis going down to low HP as well. And it looks like Orsomniac are just making content to make room for the sniper here as they try and push in and get a pick before they push last.
Yeah, they're not really committing to anything else. They're trying to come out to the Zapisai, but so much pressure from the Australian soldiers. They both go down, punishing the peak from Zapis. Kaidus has locked down the door, but surely IM are going to want to turn us into a push. So Yuki's going to want to take the Uber Exchange for now. Kaidus and Mirren have a pop, so they've just walked past him. They've just walked past him. Mirren's now going to chase him with Kaidus and the Uber. Kaidus could do him some help. He's trying to jump behind him. He's going to try and get the medic. Kaidus gets the medic. He just needs to slow it down right now. Keep his medic set. Yuki's trying to go in top. Kaidus still wants to fight, and this could be a mistake. Frag's traded up top, going favour of Orsomniac, but they lose Kaidus off the floor. Now Zappas is trying to go to last, but the fighting separated here. Zappas gets Yuki. There's only two players left alive. Starks going in, he gets piped
up
in the air.
Wow,
Turmo destroys him.
Turmo.
Zappas has arrived. Sheep's out to 8 HP. Surely Zappas can finish this when he's only 8 HP, but Nova's getting on the point. Zappas missed his shots on the weak.
Huge choke from Zappas. Surely he should have been able to finish that off. Sheep was on 8 HP and he was the only player left alive, and then there was only Bonobo, but Bonobo hadn't put any heals onto Sheep. That was an incredible choke by Zappas. The point was laid out on a platter for him and he couldn't take it. That's really unfortunate.
All of that, it's all gone and said, we're kind of back to the right whack where we were, you know, in this kind of stalemate between last
yeah.
A lot of stuff happened. Not a lot of ground was gained for either team, though, because Bonobo coming out later, it does mean Merlin has an Uber advantage.
Merlin on the left-hand side here. Stark picks up the early frag onto Yuki. Bonobo doesn't quite have his Uber, it's on 90%, and they're just stacking the point instantly. Kedda sticks off the spawn door and gets two frags, and that is the first round in favour of Orsomniac, 1-0. A nice push in there with just using the Uber advantage that they gained, a small one from building properly after a nice last push.
It was nice from them. Much more better focused fire, just really clean played, and let themselves get too separated and too distracted. And Turmo's pretty weak coming into this next middle. He's going to take a big stick in. Trading damage, Kaidus is actually worse off than this.
Kaidus going down to 23 HP there, and he has to back off to the heals from Maryland as they come in through choke. Nutson's kind of stranded on the ramp room as well, but he does get a bit of room to fight Aporia, and he's going to go down on the right hand side. Oh no, he doesn't go down. As Kaidus gets picked by Sheep, just running in. Two shots, Kaidus, and then destroys Mirrolin. Nutson gets picked up as well, and it's only Stark and also and Zebesai alive. Stark the only one with any HP. Can he do anything? He's trying to get in onto Turmo and Bonobo here, but Turmo hits a nice sticky on him. Stark's going to go down here, surely on 2 HP, but he does get onto Bonobo. Bonobo going down there to 50 HP. That was close, and that takes balls by Bonobo not to pop there.
And I'm going to claim this mid full Uber advantage, and now we're going to have to see, Orsomniac kind of failed their Uber advantage push against IM and really kind of fluffed it. I'll be wanting to see if IM can be a little bit less forgiving, a little bit less mercy, and it should be able to get yard for free. No players from Orsomniac can slow him down. And they want to go this far left hand side. Merlin's up to 50%, but he's still got quite a way to go. And Kaidus is actually holding. Where is Kaidus? He's holding.
Kaidus is in the window room.
He's in top,
above.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's got stickies. Really. Defensive stickies though, for really for pushing into last, giving second there completely for free, but they do have an engineer with a sentry and they have Stark on the heavy, so this is a full turtle strat for Orsomniac at the moment, as they just get the Uber charge and this is going to be Uber v Uber. And I don't think IM know what they're pushing into here. The sentry firing at them as well. Turmo does get a frag onto Nuts, but this Uber's not going very well for IM. Bonobo just gets stranded and taken down as Turmo gets taken down as well. Sheep and Snowblind are kind of trying to back off. Sheep here collapsing, the IM team collapsing onto Zebesai and Mirrolin, destroying them, but Kaidus comes in afterwards and picks up Snowblind and Aporia. Sheep's left alive, kind of fragging onto second point and last. And Stark comes in to try and DM this. It looks like Orsomniac are trying to pick up the second point, but they don't quite manage it as Kaidus and Stark both go down to the rockets of Yuki, and only Zappas and Nutson are left alive.
Yeah, that delay from Sheep and Distraction just made it an easy sort of 2k for Yuki to walk into. They've also got the Uber advantage, and Yuki actually wants to walk this straight into last while Kaidus and Stark are down. He's distracted from the right side. Megan Turmo is getting on the other side. They lose Zappas as well on the defense, and surely IM can just keep rolling this numbers advantage forward. Soon to be out Uber, but actually Zebesai trades, gets the Aporia frag up top. Yuki's taking a lot of spam. They're still working the doors though. Turmo trying to come in. And Osomniac really don't have a strong hold on this last right now. IAM just keep trying to work it, and now they have an Uber to back it up.
Yeah, this is a 40% advantage for Bonobo, and they do pop the Uber on the right-hand side. Yuki bombing in here, juggles Mirrorlyn right up in the air. He's on the top crate. He does take him down eventually. So that's Yuki down, that's Mirrorlyn down, and no heals for Osomniac. The backup doesn't quite materialize, unfortunate there for Nutsun, was that? Or was that one of the scouts?
Nutsun and Stark, I think they were both behind. They really committed to it, and it was awfully close, but I think one of the Australian maybe respawns or something was able to delay it. It was just enough to open it up for IAM to cap.
Zappos had previously gone for the back cap, but got shut down, mistimed it a little bit. So we're going to a middle fight again. Kade is opting for the top rollout here, and Termo going through the ramp room. We'll see who gets the better of the other team at the mid fight. At the moment, it's looking pretty passive. We don't see any aggression from anybody, but Aporia bombing in here. Big double bomb. Yuki takes on Zappos, but Aporia gets onto the combo, but doesn't quite manage to materialize any frags. Sheep and Tomo picking up frags onto the Osomniac players, and Osomniac are very weak. They managed to back out with Kadus and Stark pocketing Mirrorlyn out of there, and IAM pick up the middle. Quite a dominating performance from IAM. Nice aggression over the right hand side.
Yeah, the soldier bombs, so you know what we talked about before, where like Zebuside and Nutsun both went aggressive. They chose to go aggressive together, but they really didn't get a lot done. They didn't give a demo or the medic for people they bombed into. They were just sort of soaked up by the IAM defensive. The big players playing defensively for them, and now we're in an equal Uber exchange, and the ultimate stalemate of them all is Granary 2-3. So we won't interesting to see who makes the first move here. I mean, we've even seen Sheep swap to Sniper in this sort of stalemate because it's gone on for so long. So both teams just feeling each other right now, looking for a pick. Immune to trying to get him through the right hand side, I think.
Yeah, Yuki just kind of poking there a little bit, seeing what spam he can get out, but IAM just kind of set up on mid, content to poke, see if they can get some damage out and maybe push off that. Or something like doing kind of the same thing, but the advantage here is in favour of IAM. They have the position. Looks like they're trying to bomb in on the right-hand side. Aporia gets in onto Mirrorlyn. Mirrorlyn on 50 HP. He does pop, which was the right decision because Aporia has a nice airshot on him after that as well. Nutsun taking the last dregs of the Uber into mid to try and force Bonobo, but he gets picked up by Snowblind. And this is a 5v5 situation, but Bonobo's got the Uber charge, and Osomniac have to back all the way out to their second point. They're holding it a little bit far forward, so they might get caught out by this Uber here, but no. Kadus picks up a nice sticky trap kill onto Sheep. He's got some stickies further up as well on the point, and it looks like they're going to try and force this and maybe recontest with Sheep down a 5v6 situation. If they get a nice pop out from IAM here, they might be able to contest, maybe block. It looks like Zebuside's going to try and flank from the Z. They're going to get onto Bonobo. Bonobo has to pop, and this is what I was talking about. This is a nice pop. Zebuside getting out as well. No frags going for either team, but Zebuside from behind. He does pop the Uber and eventually gets picked up by Aporia. Snowblind go down there as well in favor of in return for Stark.
They were just, it was weird that Mirrorlyn wasn't, and Kadus was standing on separate doors, which they normally like to do. Because Zebuside was flanking, no one was with Mirrorlyn, so they've lost an opportunity to build here. They still have 40% advantage anyway, but they could already have Uber and ready to be moving forward right now. The Zebuside spawn comes in, and I think that's most likely going to cue the aggression right now. But it's always difficult to push into this because of the fast Granary spawns, and Termo already has all the traps up he wants.
Yeah, I think we might see a little bit of a stalemate situation here. I don't know whether Osomniac are going to be confident enough to push out with this small Uber advantage, and it looks like they aren't. They're letting it whittle away, and Bonobo is going to get his Uber. That's going to make it an equal Uber situation, and it's going to be on IAM to push. They've got the spawn advantage, and they've got position to push into this last and secure the round. It is, at the moment, 1-1, so neither team has any kind of imperative need to push based on the time or score, but IAM looking like they want to take it to the right hand side, but no, that's just a distraction for Aporia bombing in, seeing if he can get the Uber force. He does.
Oh, he comes in, a drop
as Snowblind hits him with a nice moon shot. That's some great distraction play, and Bonobo and the rest of his team have wisely backed out. That's a 4v4 situation, and Osomniac really aren't going aggressive here. They're not committing to try and force the Uber. They're content to hold last and try and defend it Uber v non-Uber.
Yeah, they've got Zappos on heavy, they've got Stark on sniper. Aporia's even respawned as heavy. They're waiting for the spawns here, IAM, so they're at full capacity when they go in. They can have as much damage potential as they possibly can, and that heavy as well, just to seal the deal. Merlin's gone crits because he's got more chance of getting that in the time. If IAM take their time of a push. But really, IAM should close this round out now with this big Uber advantage.
Oh, they're coming over right! Bloody shot from Stark from the back left-hand side, and he does take down Bonobo. That's a full Uber advantage negated, as Snowblind and Sheep are the only ones alive, with a very weak Termo as well, retreating back to second. It looks like Sheep was causing some nuisance behind them, which Chavez had to deal with, as Snowbun runs in, making full use of the distraction and takes down Kadus. Bonobo and Term are the only ones left alive, and they're disconnected at the moment. So I don't know whether IM are going to be able to block this second point. I don't think they are, but Term and both the soldiers now coming onto it. Fast granary spawns, but the crit's coming out. Zebesai gets instantly destroyed by Aporia, but Stark gets the crits put onto him. Nice weak shot to take down Aporia, but I still don't think they're going to be able to take this, and they retreat to last. But this is going to be equal Uber by the time they get it, but it's going to be a crit from Mirrolin. I am not even willing to let that happen as they push him from the right-hand side. Non-Uber push here. Nice play from IM as they're picking up frags left, right, and center.
Yeah, they're really putting them back right now. Zaps is going to be isolated. Zebesai is going to respawn. Zibby's going to go down straight away. Kadus is having to jump up, trying to get as much stickies on the point as he can, but he's completely overwhelmed. There's all the iron players are still up, but half of them still have a buff. They're going to finish that off, and that's 2-1 to immunity right now. 30 minutes left.
Raise your Australian herons. They're rustling pots and pans all over the place around here.
We're going into the next mid right now, and it looks like Termo's come in the standard way. It looks like Kadus wants to come out up top. Termo's predicted that though, knocks Kadus down straight away. Kadus on the back foot on this mid. Termo's down to half health though. The soldiers are starting to arrive now. Expect big aggression from the Swedes straight away, but Yuki's actually the first to go in. All over Kadus and Mirrolin, knocks him back. Aggression's being traded right now. Frags, two apiece on both sides. Zebesai and Nutsen have the high ground. But Termo's going to take down Nutsen. Zebesai's going to drop on him. He's still got to fight Snowblind though. Snowblind's going to clean that up. And where's Stark and Mirrolin on the point now? Snowblind's thinking about it, even though Stark has the full buffs.
Yeah, Snowblind really confident in his DM. Oh, and she comes up from behind. A great pick onto Mirrolin. They combine there, using the distraction of Snowblind, but Stark picks up the frag onto Sheep. But Sheep, I think, tried to use his boss and basher to kill Stark there. Stark picks up both of the frags. Great DM from Stark. Really confident, even without those heals. After Mirrolin went down, he picked up both the frags onto the Australian scouts, showing that he's good enough to tangle with the big boys.
Yeah, really safe now after Mirrolin dropped. Like, I think they just lost track of Sheep during that middle when he just kind of dropped down behind him when no one knew he was there. He got the medic pick, and that's going to give Bonobo a 30-40% advantage, maybe a little bit more. Mirrolin's only just meeting up with someone. So Immunity have the undesirable task of pushing from Granary CP2 to middle.
They do, but they are 2-1 up at the moment, so they're perfectly content, I would imagine, just to sit on Granary Yard and wait for the other team to push into them. It depends whether they want to squander this 45% advantage they've been gifted by the scouts of IM as they managed to pick up Mirrolin on the last midfight. Osomnia called it incredibly passive at the moment on their own balcony, giving IM a lot of room to maneuver if they have a peek through, but IM have no idea because they have nobody scouting it out at the moment. Nuts on the only one further forward, I would imagine that he's going to go for a force if IM decide to push this in. But with Mirrolin now getting his Uber charge, it looks like they were content just to hold yard, not satisfied with that 45% Uber advantage, not confident in their ability to push onto Granary, which is quite the task.
Yeah, just playing it safe. I understand the decision to play it safe, but there is still 11 minutes left. Like, they can't really wear the clock down for 11 minutes at this point. I really think they should have at least tried to go forward, and now it's going to be on Osomniac. Zebesai's going to try and come in, but he's actually peppered back from the scout. Zebesai will go down. Is this going to cube a push? It looks like Yuki wants to go. He's getting straight through that door. He's going to come through this left-hand side. Kadus has swapped over. Kadus has predicted where they're coming from. Kadus gets a lot of damage out, but Yuki gets through. Kadus can do it for you, but actually, Bonobo's going to drop both Yuki and Termo. He's going to flash it onto a scout, and we're going to try and chase for a terrible Uber from IM, and Kadus punished them for that.
Yeah, that was great by Kadus. He read the IM team perfectly. There was four players all bunched up in the choke there, and Kadus knew that even though the Uber was coming through and he had a soldier onto his medic, he knew that they would deal with him, the rest of his team would deal with them, and he came in, did tons of damage to those four players, clumped up in such a small area, and made the Uber so much better for Osomniac, and they pushed through the yard and get the second point for free. And this is going to be an Uber v Uber situation. The Uber's perfectly equal at the moment, but Sheep is spawned on a defensive sniper, and it looks like Yuki's holding the door open for him to get some kind of pick, but Stark comes in and frags Aporia. I have no idea where that is. I guess Aporia was through into garage or something like that.
Yeah, he must have been behind, and Zebesai goes down as well, and I am holding really far close, trying to get Sheep and Anger right now. They're trying to peek around, but they have to be careful because Murren's getting awfully close to that Uber, and Kadus is close to that door, and they're rightly backing off right now, putting some distance between them. And we see a spy from Zebesai again. I've never really seen Zebesai go spy outside of Nisp's best of three series right now. It looks like he wants to go up top and go around that way. Be interesting to see if he can get anything done. He's through without being in. He avoids taking full damage.
He took a big rocket as soon as he... he took a big rocket as soon as he came out that window. Just a random spam rocket, and they know that he's a spy, and they know that he's around here somewhere. Zebesai, unfortunately, going down then. Nothing materializing from the spy play there from Zebesai. Sheep changes from the sniper back to the scouters. They want to push with this pick. It's basically a pocket pick, even though he was on spy there. So Stark picks up Aporia, who's overextended, trying to get something done, maybe a force onto Merlin, something like that. And IM just sit back. They realize that they've gone 5v6, and they don't want to push into Granary second with that kind of disadvantage.
Yeah, time's whistling away right now, and Osomniac need to make something happen. They've got the normal standard aggressive six classes on the field, so I imagine we're going to go for more of a normal trade. It looks like they're just buffing people up. Are we going to go for a suicide again? I think Zebesai and Zappas have a normal suicide pair for these, in this team.
Yeah, it's... it looks like it's Nutsun and Zappas going in, but Zappas instantly gets... Zappas instantly gets took down by a sticky trap, and Nutsun just walks straight into Yuki and gets absolutely destroyed. Zebesai picks up Sheep and Snowblind, though, who go a little bit too aggressively into the top. And Osomniac picking up all the frags. It looks like they just baited them into a little bit of a push there. They had no support from their combo or any of their heavy players, and they got utterly ruined. And now the Ubers have been forced from IM. The Uber is so much better from Osomniac, and they're 5v3 in this situation. Surely this is going to be a round picked up for Osomniac, unless the spawns come in. But Termo does go down, that means no stickies on the point. Yuki picks up two in return, but Kadus gets the frags onto Aporia and Snowblind. It's only Bonobo and Sheep left alive, but Sheep's wrecking kids. Oh, Stark with a shot to Bonobo, but Sheep does pick
him up. Zebesai's going for it. Zebesai's jumping in right now. He's not scouting the air. He's not landed any rockets. He's down to 40 health. Is Nutsun coming in as well? No.
This is great play by Sheep so far, though. That was a great defense by him. I think he picked up three frags there, and absolutely crucial, saving the round for his team. Snowblind kills himself?
Yep. Well, Sheep was doing such a good work on that defense. Snowblind divided. He had the time to go, you know, respawn again. He had plenty of time. You've got this, mate. Don't worry. I
think maybe he tried to switch class to engineer or something like that, but it was outside the spawn doors, and he's got that that option. I actually remember seeing one of the previous I-series where Shintaz did that on Gully Wash.
I think I know what you mean, yeah. But again, we're in a stalemate. Well, say stalemate for now, and there's an uber advantage with Merlin. It looks like they want to go up top. It's going to be Zebesai and Stark, or both scouts even. Both scouts coming in up top. They're trying to find a target to focus. They've not really found anything to shoot just yet, and now is a sentry. Munich has done a really good job of scattering. Yuki comes in behind him and just sandwiches them here. They only get, what, two frags out of that? Kadus desperately jumps for points at the end and gets picked up by the sentry, and a terrible push considering that was uber advantage.
Yeah, they had a small uber advantage, but Bonobo was positioned so far back that the dual scout uber couldn't get anywhere near him, and they chased him into spawn so that there was no heals, but by the time they got all the way back there, the uber had completely faded, and IM collapsed onto them really nicely, got some high ground and destroyed the Osomniac players that were in there. And it looked also like they had no idea that Snowblind was running engineer, because they were completely off guard by that sentry.
Yeah, Zebesai's now going in to try and get a force on Bonobo. Bonobo's up in the air. He does get air shot, but he does pop. Yeah, Bonobo knew he had to pop. Saw that rocket coming for him. Beautiful force by Zebesai, and Merlin's going to leapfrog the Ubers. They're going to give away middle here, Osomniac, but they will have an uber advantage to push back in with. And Osomniac needs something. They're a round down with 6 minutes left. Both teams playing for their lives in this I-52 Summer LAN.
Yeah, this is the decider map between Osomniac and IM in the lower bracket, so whoever loses this map is going to be knocked out of the tournament. IM having a blaze of a tournament so far, doing really well, but they're coming up. They've met their match here in Osomniac. They've taken them to two rounds. Aporia has gone into the ramp room here and has forced the Uber from Mirrolin. The Osomniac player is streaming forward here, trying to get something done. Kadus bombs in, just take down Bonobo. Great bomb with stickies from Kadus. He sacrifices his life there in exchange for the medic pick. And Osomniac, the rest of the Osomniac team
Sheeps
are going to pick up those frags.
He's down to 50 and he actually pushes him into Termo Sticky. Termo's coming in and cleaned up two players right now. Stark's going to kill Sheep, and Termo's still on the middle point, but Stark's on low HP trying to hunt him down. Scout v Demo 1v1, both on low health. Nobody wants to commit. Oh, Termo snipes him. Turner with a prediction. It's not going to mean a lot though, as Kaedas arrives with full health from the respawn, and I'm usually going to have to back out, but they do have uber advantage. Merlin swap into crits.
IAM have got better respawns here as well, so they should be able to get to the midpoint before Orsomniac do. It depends whether they want to contest this. It looks like they're coming through ramp room now, but they're going to meet the stickies of Kaedas. He's got them outside this ramp room. Yuki spots them, and that's going to delay them way too long, and they back out to Yard. And that's going to settle this out. It's Chris Krieg from Merlin CX.
Yeah, should we go? Let's go to Orsomniac comms if we can, Atmo, see what they're thinking with this crit. So I don't know if they want to be aggressive. It looks like they want to be defensive, bait out the aggression from immunity, but I don't think immunity is going to go forward. So let's listen to the comms and see what they're planning.
Force and then crit. If they don't push, we force with crits and then turtle up.
I don't think they're going to push.
Okay. Then spot medic on me. Don't show the Merlin, but spot medic. Tell me whereabouts he's standing.
Medic is at right yard, right at the back of the door. He's between the silo thing on the right and the back door. He's next to the pile of wood now.
I'm gonna have a quick look. Merlin, on me.
He's moving constantly.
Okay.
He's at the door now. He's at the door now.
I missed. Merlin!
David.
Give me spam rockets. I'm going for ammo.
I'm not testing.
I took the one right.
We saw them with a plan there. They knew immunity weren't going to push. They knew they had to go, but Bonobo's reactions were solid, and we're just going to sort of see a repeat right now as Merlin and Kaedas are going to build up that crits charge once again, or maybe Orsomniac, they're pretty close to this door. Maybe they just want to go straight in, but immunity have got good spam on them. We're not letting them have an inch right there. 3.5 minutes left. Orsomniac need a round before this is over if they want to stay in the tournament.
Orsomniac are going to have a fair uber advantage here as they're running the Critskrieg. Critskrieg and uber popped off at the same time last time, which means that the Critskrieg will have something like a 25% uber advantage by the time it builds. It is at the moment activated.
Kaedas is peaking, and Kaedas is coming in. He's missed Bonobo though. Bonobo's going to get the uber in time. Soldier's going to drop down, kill Merlin and kill Kaedas. Scout might be able to avenge him right now. Zappas gets one, but that's so many down right now. Snowbine's going to kill Zappas, and it's only Nutson left alive on 53 health.
That was really unlucky there from Kaedas. One of his crit stickies did hit Bonobo, but it was on the very, very edge of the blast radius, and he was dropped down to 18 health, and then popped his uber as he just got it. He was on 90% as they came in with that Critskrieg there. Looks like Nutson wants to contest this midpoint, Orsomniac realizing that they can't really give this up with such little time left, but they're going to lose the frag there, and they're going to have to be content with holding yard and having to push back into granary mid, which is always a task, especially when they're going to be running Critskrieg against Bonobo's uber, and it's going to be even by the time they get it.
It's going to be difficult for them, but they've only got 2 minutes. They have to make something. They have to make a move now. It looks like they want to go left-hand side with Zebesai. He's walking through with Murin, his medic. They're pretty close. Zebesai doesn't want to commit too much. He's just trying to bait him forward, bait him into Zappas. But Yuki's now going forward with Fluba. They have crits, but Yuki's getting straight onto Merlin. He sends Merlin up. He finishes Merlin with an air rocket. Zebesai's hit two on Yuki, but it doesn't matter because he's invulnerable. He's going to be cleaned up, but the flank is coming out for Orsomniac. Both scouts have gone for a back cap right now. I'm not sure if this will work if Immunity just stacked the point. Kaedas is delaying them, but I don't know how much he can delay. Kaedas and Nutson go down, and Immunity are going to cap it, and they're going to rush to last. Stark and Zappas are nowhere near, and surely Immunity are going to cap this out with 1 minute 30 seconds remaining.
And that's good game to IM. It's a really valiant effort by Orsomniac. They put up a great match, but IM just inching them out right at the end there with Orsomniac having to push with their crit speed because the time was ticking down. Unfortunately, they get the worst end of that against Bonobo's uber with some incredible soldier DM there coming out at the end. Some brilliant air shots. But unfortunately, yeah, Zebesai hitting them on shiny people. You can't do damage to them, Zebesai.
Let's watch Kaedas on mid. I think he's going to go aggressive. He's done the slow rollout. He's going all the way in. He's going to try and bomb in. He bombs right behind everyone. Can't find a lot of damage right now. Hits one sticky kill, tries to fight for scout, misses. Somniac with the strong mids closing out their land right now. Merlin and a couple of those scouts are the only ones left, and they will win middle, and that will probably be pretty much their last act for this LAN. Sideshow, what are your thoughts, Fen? Somniac out.
Yeah, rest in peace, European dreams. As long as Epsilon are able to create something, you know, some drama in the upper bracket, I'm fine. I really want them to be able to get to the final so that it's a, well, if it was a FroyoTech IM final as well, I would be satisfied. A multi-continental final is what I'm after. But as Bones is waving the European seagull as it flaps in a terrible final descent.
This is fought by everyone, Bones. So looking at the logs, you can just see the dominance from my end. I don't know if Ammo's got the stream yet, or if we're just closing out the round as they still play. But the first thing I see from the logs is Turmo, Yuki, and Sheep all top on the damage. Just even Zebesai are quite low down. Everyone low on damage because of all the stalemates. But it's just Zebesai and Kade has not shown the normal dominance you'd expect from them in a map. In any matchup, really.
Yeah, Turmo going big this map. I'm really impressed by his ability to DM. He goes 22 for 9 with the least deaths on the server matching the amount of deaths of his medic, Bonobo. Turmo MVP says bye. He knows what he's talking about. So yeah, I'm very impressed with how Turmo is playing. He went huge earlier on in the tournament. I think he went 21 for 3 in one of the games that they wrecked people in. And he's really brought it this game as well. You can get in a large amount of heals that game compared to what Zebesai normally gets. You said earlier about Osomniac kind of changing their heal spread a little bit, giving Kadus more than they normally do. I was specking a lot of the games previously, and I've seen that Zebesai gets a lot of the heals compared to the rest of his team. The flank in this game getting a rather large amount of the heals compared to what you'd normally expect from Osomniac. And I am playing with a very dominant pocket. Yuki there taking 11k heals with 33% of Bonobo's Medigun.
Just dominant all around. We saw that Turmo's been playing fantastically. We're really impressed with him. Didn't know a lot going into the LAN. He doesn't die. He pumps out the damage. He gets the frags. He's as fast as Kadus most of the time.
Yeah.
He matches Kadus. He hits Kadus with these like stickies. The initial demo fight. You just see. I think you can see on stream when it just happens with Zebesai and Yuki shaking hands. So they will advance. So I believe that means they play mix-up. Immunity will play mix-up in the next game.
Which should be an incredible match. Immunity against mix-up. That's Australia against America there with the loser being knocked out. So
the loser knocked out, the winner goes on to play Epsilon for a place in the grand final tomorrow.
And it'll be a terrible shame if either of those teams do get knocked out at this point.
So I think that's all we're going to have for now. We're going to bring you the rest of the lower bracket later on. Most likely on stream one, there's only going to be single games going on now. So this is the end of Team Fortress TV 2 for I-52. Everything's going to be on the mainstream right now. So swap over to Nat for all the information on when the next matches are coming. Thanks for watching. See you on stream one.
Yeah.